try to understand the characteristic graph for PN junction itself right now. So this is PN junction diode. Now, in order to draw characteristic graph, we have to measure potential difference and current across the diode and see the different values, measure it, and then plot the graph. Simple. Okay. So the overall circuit to do that, it's like this. You have a PN junction. By the way, this is how you represent a PN junction in a circuit, like this. Okay. This flat side, this is P side and this is N side. Okay. So you have a PN junction like that. And in order to measure the potential difference across a PN junction, you connect a voltmeter across a PN. Fine. And I also have to measure the current through the diode. Fine. So this is milliammeter. And then it is connected like this. Tell me whether it is forward bias or reverse bias.
Forward. No, forward.
It is forward because P side is connected to the positive terminal of the battery. Okay. Now, this potential difference, which is the supply voltage, I can change. So that is why there is an arrow like that. Fine. So I can change this voltage, vary it, and accordingly, I'll get the different values of V and I. Okay, so this is forward bias. Now for a reverse bias also, I can have a very similar looking circuit, right? So we'll have a circuit now in a reverse bias, negligible amount of current flows. So rather than milliammeter, I'll connect microammeter. Okay, so that the slightest of the current that is there should be measured. This is the reverse bias now, and I am connecting a voltmeter across a diode like this.
So reverse bias, there should be no current only, no?
See, reverse bias, there is a small amount of current that happens. Okay, let me show you what we have discussed earlier. See, this is the reverse bias. This one is reverse bias. Okay, so if few electrons from this side jump to P side, then there will be a current. Right now, the electron that could jump from N side to P side, that is because of what? Because of diffusion. Are you getting it? So higher concentration is on the N side. P side has lower concentration. When equilibrium is attained, then this width is, you know, constant. So there will be a small amount of diffusion current because of the flow from higher concentration to lower concentration. Fine. But then that is negligible. So that is why we say that it is like insulator. But then if you supply tremendous amount of voltage, suppose you supply huge voltage, then breakdown may happen. What do I mean by breakdown is that all these valence electron which are there in this junction barrier, all the bonds will get broken, and then you have a lot of free charge carriers to carry the electricity. Fine. So in a reverse bias also, if I have huge amount of voltage, then at a certain point the entire junction diode will break and a surge of current you will observe. So if I plot current versus voltage using these circuit. Okay, treating reverse bias as negative voltage and forward bias as positive voltage, and this is what I'll get. This is current in the milliampere. This is voltage. Okay. Now, if I say that a positive voltage is forward bias and a negative voltage is reverse bias, then since current also changes its direction, I can say that the current in the reverse bias is negative and current in the forward bias is positive. Fine. So when it comes to forward bias, you will have a plot in the first quadrant where voltage and current both are positive. And if it is reverse bias, then since voltage and current both are negative, it will come in the third quadrant. Fine. Now tell me that if I supply small amount of voltage in the forward bias, like very, very less, let's say 0.01 volt, what will happen? Will there be any current? Are you guys there?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Will there be any current? Oh, Amog is watching from YouTube. I didn't know that. Amog, you can also answer. Amog, you went to picnic? You're watching this from your picnic spot? Are you at home? You are at home. Tell me, if I have a very small voltage applied, let's say 0.01 volt, will there be any current? Yes or no?
So I'm not sure.
See, when you apply a very small amount of current, very small amount of voltage, let's say 0.01 volt, that voltage may not be sufficient for electron to jump over that barrier which was created earlier. Fine. The electron has to jump from N side to P side for electricity to get conducted. And in between, there is a potential barrier. So external voltage should be more than that junction barrier, then only current will flow. Fine. So typically, the junction barrier in forward bias is around 0.6 to 0.7 volt. Fine. So if you are applying a battery of voltage less than 0.6, 0.7, then the diode will not get activated. The current will be close to zero only. But if you apply, let's say 1 volt or 3 volt, then electrons will gain sufficient kinetic energy to overcome the barrier and there will be a good amount of current. Okay, and the entire diode will behave like a conductor with a potential difference of whatever is a junction barrier. Okay, let's first draw the diagram, then I'll speak more about it. This is how it will be. It goes like this and then it grows. This is around 0.8 volts where it starts jumping. This is the knee voltage. Fine. This is the forward bias characteristic. All right. So let's say I have a diode. So this is P and this is N. And a resistance R, this is connected like that. Let's say this is 5 volt. Can you guess what will be the current? How much is the current? This PN junction will act like a reverse voltage of 0.7 volt. So the current will be equal to 5 minus 0.7, which is forward bias junction barrier, divided by R. Fine. That's how.
So what? So could you repeat that once? I didn't get that part.
See, what I was saying, that in forward bias, PN junction just creates a junction barrier, okay, of let's say around 0.7 volt. And after that junction barrier, if you overcome that, it behaves like a metal. Okay, so if you supply external voltage of 5 volt, 0.7 volt it requires to overcome the barrier, and rest of the voltage you can treat as if it is connected to a metal piece. Fine. So 5 minus 0.7 volt is the effective voltage across the resistance R. So in a forward bias, it behaves like this. Fine. Now comes the reverse bias. In reverse bias, you have negative potential connected to the P side. Fine. So in a forward bias, I'm slowly increasing the voltage and current increases very fast. In reverse bias, I can increase the voltage faster. I can say that this 20 volt, this is 40, 60, this is around 80. Fine. So if I do that and then measure the current and voltage, then this is what I will get. It goes on like this, and then there is sudden surge of current. This is the breakdown that happens. This is breakdown voltage. At this voltage, the entire diode breaks down. What do you mean by breaking down is that at the junction barrier, the bonds get broken off and a lot of free electrons get generated that can start conducting electricity. Fine. So there's a surge of free electrons, and then the y-axis measures the current. And in the reverse bias, I am not measuring current in milliampere, but I am measuring in microampere. Okay, because it's a very small amount of current up till 80 volts, till the breakdown happens. Okay, now one thing which is noticeable in this graph is that, you know, this particular portion, this portion is flat. Why it is flat? Because after 80 volt, one breakdown happens, then it becomes exactly like a metal piece. There is no junction barrier also, and sudden surge of electron comes in, and also there is a large amount of external potential that is around 80 volt is already there. So suddenly current will rise, and this line could be very flat. Okay, you may think that in a forward bias also this line is flat, but then if you notice on the x-axis, the potential is increasing very slowly, 0.1, 0.2, up to 0.8. Okay, so a flat looking line here and a flat looking line this side, where the potential is changing rapidly, there's a much there is a lot of difference. Okay, a flat line over here is way flatter or more steeper than this line. Because here this entire axis is shrinked and this axis is stretched. So even after stretching the axis, this line remains flat. Fine. So I can say that after breakdown, the voltage is sort of constant. Any doubt till now?
No, sir.
Fine. So this is with respect to the characteristic of the PN junction diode. Now, there is no point defining, you know, a static resistance for this particular. What is static resistance? A ratio between voltage and current. So there is no point talking about static resistance, because at every point it changes. And usually what happens, we are going to use a PN junction at the varying voltage scenario or varying current scenario. What we do, we measure the dynamic resistance, that is change in voltage divided by change in current. Okay, this is called dynamic resistance at any point in time. Okay, because the slope of V and I is not a constant. So this is not a straight line. Okay, even that may not be exactly straight line. So there is a curved portion also here. So what we do, we measure delta V by delta I and say that that is the dynamic resistance. Fine. So